Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed, and today we got CHUGS.
Yeah, baby. What's going on?
Nothing much. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great. I'm doing great. I'm excited to check this out today. I'll tell you that, though.
Today, we're going to get down on some WWE SuperCard.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. It's the good stuff. And those of you who have been playing, you already know that Season 7 is upon us.
Season 7, baby.
Tons of new things we want to touch on. Make sure you guys are getting the entire picture. Because just because you've been playing doesn't mean you've explored everything yet. And then for you new booties who are coming through for the game for the first time, we're going to explain why you need to be here and what things you have to play. So,
yes.
First thing we're going to touch on is the fact that sometimes the different game modes that you want to play, it might be Royal Rumble, it might be Elimination Chamber. You might have to wait for those to come up. Chugs, do you like waiting?
I personally hate waiting. If I could never wait again for the rest of my life, that would be great. That'd be great.
And that's what SuperCard's doing for y'all right now. We're going to click PvP. And all those modes I talked about, look at that. Women's Royal Rumble. Royal Rumble. War.
That is so convenient.
Bam.
So convenient.
Elimination Chamber. Women's Elimination Chamber. You can play it whenever you want.
So you could wake up one day and go, I want to do an Elimination Chamber right now. And you could just do it.
Why not? Beautiful. Why not? Feel like going to Royal Rumble on a Wednesday morning? Psh, psh. Why not? Why not?
Yes.
You've got all these fantastic modes that you can play now whenever you want through the PvP in Season 7. But what we're going to do first before we dig into that is show off some of these Season 7 cards.
Yes. I've been waiting for this. I've been waiting for this.
We're going to start with Batista.
Dang, man. Look at him.
Behemoth card. That's the new top tier in this Season 7. Oh, it was Behemoth.
Behemoth cards look really, really cool.
They really do.
Really, really cool.
But I got something to show you, Cole.
What?
Bam!
Oh my goodness gracious.
Look at you.
That's the best looking Behemoth card I've seen yet. Gosh, look at me.
Adam Cole, look at Behemoth.
That seriously is probably the coolest card I've seen of mine. Anyway, like as far as the whole setup goes, wow.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Dude, I just love the kaiju in the background. Monster just destroying the buildings.
I know, very appropriately named Behemoth.
100%.
Perfect.
And so we got Behemoth cards. Then our next tier down is going to be our Swarm cards. And so obviously,
oh, those are cool too.
It's really cool looking at the beehive in the back. Got all this stuff going on. Got a little
nice.
Bit of Drew. Oh, there we go. Oh, here we go.
Oh, EO.
Ooh,
wonderful. Yeah, wonderful.
And fellow Departee member.
Oh,
we got Swiss.
A lot of respect.
So
a lot
much
of respect, Swissman.
So much.
Yes.
Yes. And then underneath the Swarm cards, we've got biomechanical cards.
Oh, and these are all new.
Yes, these are all new Season 7.
Man, they dropped a lot. This is cool.
There's a lot going on. There's a lot going on. We got Mustafa Ali in here. Let's see. Oh, we got Retribution coming through. We got T-Bar. We got Mace. And we got Slapjack.
Yes, Slapjack, baby. Look at that face.
With the new things about these cards in Season 7, we'll do it with the fantastic Adam Cole Behemoth card.
Amazing. So
if I go down and click Improve, obviously you guys who have played, you understand we got Power, Toughness, Speed, Charisma. These are the things that we've used so far to get ahead in this game.
Definitely.
They're throwing a little curveball at you to make the game a little more full of depth. So here, you've got Superstar Style. So right under the word Behemoth, up in the top right, you can see that microphone. That is Adam Cole's style. He's an orator. Means he's nasty on the mic.
Yeah,
ain't that right?
That's true. True. It's no lies there.
your style allows you to have certain techniques. And so since Adam Cole's card here is an orator, he can only have certain techniques. And so those techniques are down here below at the very bottom of the card. You see defend. That's his current technique. So that means after the match, if you activate it, then you have a 20% chance to reduce damage taken by 5% in the next match.
Oh, that's great.
So if you're getting rocked in that first match and then you activate defend, then in your next match, you have the chance to have your damage taken reduced by 5%. So with this technique, let's say, oh, but Creed, I got all these high level Season 6 cards that I don't want to get rid of and I don't want to be at a disadvantage. You won't be. because you only need one season 7 card with these abilities in order to enact that technique.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes.
That's right. I was thinking that same thing. Mm-hmm. So that's awesome.
Mm-hmm. So nobody's getting their cards nullified or clipped or anything like that. You can still use these techniques. And if you don't like that Adam Cole has this defend technique, you can click this circle right here on the right-hand side on the bottom, and you can re-roll to get a different technique.
Oh.
And so if you click the eye next to defend, there's even more information. So we're on defend currently. You've got inspire, reversal, and assist. So wow. These are all things that will help you in those matches to get ahead. And if your numbers are a little bit low, but you got a good technique, now you can kind of sway the game in your favor a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going to be on all the Season 7 cards from here throughout. But again, just to reiterate, those of you who have been putting time in and putting work in, you are going to have the opportunity to just have one of these cards in your deck in order to pop off that technique to help save your skin when you need it.
Yeah, that's really nice. And I am sure, too, if you had multiple Season 7s, you could have different techniques there at the bottom. Like one guy has defend, one guy could use reversal. That's cool.
Mm-hmm. So now people are playing chess instead of checkers.
Mm. Uh-oh. I'm not very good at chess.
All right, so for all of our up, up, down, down people out there, we got a little something for you. You guys already got that up, up, down, down sweet card back. But now, what everybody on the SuperCard side has been kind enough to do is up, up, down, down's getting their own collection.
Oh, that's amazing.
Yes. And it starts off on December 8th. And that first little piece is going to be an Xavier Woods biomechanical card.
I bet that one's awesome.
Oh, yeah.
I bet
it's
so awesome.
It's so nice. It's so nice. And so you'll see what else is going to be in there once it pops up. But December 8th, be ready. Be prepared.
I jumped in a little late. But
oh, no. That works. That works. You can hold it out. It's more dramatic effect. So we're going to jump back into this PvP deal so you guys can see that these modes work regardless of what time it is.
Beautiful.
We're in war, searching for an opponent.
Going back to war. People are excited.
Put all those other cards back in there.
Let's see where
we
are.
Here we go.
Ooh.
Okay. Okay. I'll fight Mankind.
Starting off with Mankind. Okay.
I like that.
Okay. On Monday Night Raw.
All right. So we got a solo match. Boom. Mm. Power and charisma. We got Triple H. We got Egg Triple H, and we got
you know who I'm voting for. Egg already, Triple H.
It threw us in.
I'm just saying Egg Triple H is gonna be our MVP.
All right, perfect. Egg Triple H is coming to the top.
Egg Triple H.
Oh, look, stomping down the ramp.
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go, Ivar.
All right, I think we got this.
Come on.
I think whoa!
Come on. Yeah, with the card come back on it.
Yeah, baby.
There we go.
That's how it's done.
Bow down to the king.
All right. We got power and toughness. You know what? We can go Egg Triple H.
Yeah, if we could please be 100%. Egg Triple H, that'd be great.
Could be Egg Triple H. There we go.
Oh, that's Egg Triple H against Baron Corbin, it looks like.
I'll take that.
Oh, man. Okay, yeah. This is going to be a massacre. Look at him.
If I don't see Egg Triple H on TV,
he's powered up.
I'm going to be very upset. Oh, he kicked him. Oh, pedigree.
Low blow pedigree. Egg Triple H is the best. He's the best.
He's not a good guy. He's not a bad guy. He's just the guy. All right. And so we've got this meter down here in the bottom left. Once that's full, we can click that and we're going to knock off a super move. So here we go.
Oh, okay. That's crazy looking.
All right.
I love it. Oh, man.
So
I love it.
Save them. Save them until you need them.
Yeah,
save
exactly.
Them until you need
definitely
them.
Don't be throwing those around randomly.
My God.
Pick the right time. Jeez, that was sick.
Oiling our hair. Polishing the title belts. Stretching spandex. Do you oil your hair? Do you put you have a mix of things you put in your hair?
Never. No. So when I, the first 6 months I wrestled, I used to put baby oil in my hair.
Oh. God, in your hair.
I didn't know. I was just why? Like, oh, I gotta keep. I thought that's what people did to keep their hair wet. Until finally someone was like, no, you gotta use conditioner, man. Baby oil is disgusting.
Yeah.
And then changing to conditioner, oh my God, it made it so much better.
So
it was gross.
Because, like, how long would it take to get all the baby oil out of your hair?
God, I feel like my hair was permanently baby oiled.
Yeah.
Like, it took, like, I never feel like I got it out. I feel like just last month I finally got all the baby oil out of my hair from when I was 19.
You're just like, yep, that's the last bit of it. Perfect.
I used to use that stuff called hot stuff,
too. Oh, I remember hot stuff.
And then I'll never forget one time I put it on, and I had, like, an 8-minute match, and I was blown up in the lockup. I was so, I used to take pre-workout right before, hot stuff on. Now I walk around and breathe heavy and don't take anything before I wrestle.
So for people who don't understand, can you explain what hot stuff was and why people used it?
Yeah, so again, for me at the time, I put hot stuff on because it actually turned your skin, for me, a little bit red. And I felt a little bit more vascular, like more pumped up, ready to go. It kind of like, again, I swear to me at that time, I felt like it made me look bigger. It made the smell of it got me all jacked up, ready to go. problem is though, it like, when I would put it on, I think because it closes your pores, like the first 10 seconds of the match, I was dead, exhausted. They couldn't go.
It's so when you're talking about like the smell got you like jacked up, like it's so weird up. Because like I'd be in a locker room, so I never use hot stuff because I'm blessed with this milk chocolate, you know. But like that's what the locker room would smell like right before the showtime, because like at least one person's got it on already,
right?
And so I would always ask like, oh, you know, who am I wrestling tonight? Because like there were like two or three guys that didn't use hot stuff, and I just want to wrestle them. Because whenever I got it on me, I just felt like I'd lock up with somebody, and then it's all over my chest.
Yep.
And like, I just, you can't see it because it's clear, obviously, but I just feel it on my skin. And I'm like, no, it's like acid to me.
I know. God.
But that was the smell.
When you think about it too, like, again, I also, there was a small phase before I discovered hot stuff where I put, I would do like a ton of baby oil. Like, not like a little bit of baby oil and water, but like, a ton of baby oil. So dangerous. Just like, I pretty much showered in the stuff before I went out there. And be like, oh man, you're so slippery. So, but when I found hot stuff, the stuff that made me feel all jacked up, plus kind of like baby oil, I was like, this is my jam, but it was my jam for one match. Or one or two matches, maybe.
Then you're in. I'm just imagining like a young Adam Cole just putting baby oil in the bottom of his boots before he goes out. Just getting real slick.
Yeah, just getting real slick. Really real wanted slick. To test myself, you know?
Yeah.
Early on in my career.
Well, dude, God. If he could do this with baby oil on his boots, what can he do when he's dry?
Exactly. There is nothing worse than being 35 minutes into a match. Your hair is completely dry. You're choking on it. You're like, you're trying to get it out of your mouth. It's the worst. I wish there was a way for me to keep my hair just soaking wet 24/7, even when I sleep, you know?
You just got a plastic pillowcase. Your whole place is set up like grandma's furniture. Just plastic all over everything.
But I'd be going to bed knowing that I look like a rock star, you know what
oh,
I mean?
Yeah.
Just,
oh, yes.
Just drenched.
Just waking up, the whole back of your neck is like you've been in the bathtub for 10 hours. Just wrinkled. And
just the most. Yeah, here comes wrinkly neck. Such a. The back of my neck is just constantly wrinkly.
Here comes old wrinkled neck.
Here comes old wrinkly neck. Here he comes. He's 27 years old. Look at him.
Back of his neck looks like he's 93. Yeah.
I'm gonna do it now.
But as we move a little bit past that, we have you here because we want to talk to you about something very, very important. And you have done battle in war games. Can you talk about what it feels like to be in battle in war games?
Well, God, not only have I been in battle in war games before, but I've actually been in every single war games match in NXT history.
What?
Every single one.
What?
The first one that we did, I managed to win. But as far as what you go through, what your body goes through, mentally what you go through, for me personally, it's the scariest, but also the most exhilarating match that I've ever been in. Again, you've got in many cases, eight guys, people running in at different time periods. You want to make sure your team has the advantage. You also need to be comfortable with the idea of knowing that you're going to wake up the next day in so much pain and so sore and so thankful to be alive. I think I've gotten thrown off the top of a War Games cage more than anybody as well. So I have a love-hate relationship with War Games. Yeah.
Hell yeah. Well, I want to talk about that because War Games is now a part of SuperCard.
Yes.
Yeah, we got it in.
Yes.
War Games is played a total across three rounds, right?
Sweet.
So each round has two phases, the deployment phase and the reconcile phase. So currently, War Games is a four-day-long event. And each of the rounds, players are dealt four cards from their event deck. Now, the AI and the player then take turns placing down cards, and those are face down. And when the deployment phase ends, the cards flip and the battle starts. So after the battle happens, cards can be damaged or KO'd. So if you have a refresh boost, card returns an injured player. So if you play that refresh boost, you get a player back. And you get them back to normal, essentially, without them getting KO'd. A tag out boost card can clear a KO'd card from the ring. And then players can also use the points doubler to earn more points from each round. And all these can be purchased with credits. So. So essentially, you've got your cards, you put them face down, you flip them, and then whoever wins, wins. Whoever's damaged is damaged. And then with these credits that you have, you can purchase different cards in order to alter the cards of yours that are currently on the table.
That's really cool.
So whether it's getting them back to full health, whether it's tagging them out and putting new cards in. So that way, it really has that War Games vibe.
Got to.
Yeah, and so in these decks, so your War Games deck is gonna be comprised of 16 superstars, and War Games can either be an all-men's division or an all-women's division event. And the event is scheduled to take place over the course of 4 days and will be inserted into SuperCard's event schedule. And so this is SuperCard's sixth event. So they're constantly bringing stuff to the table, which is nice to see, always evolving.
I'm very happy to see War Games involved. Like, maybe the most stoked I've been.
Right, because this is your deal. You're the War Games guy.
It is. I'm the War Games king. So to see that this event's finally making it here is awesome. It sounds great too. That's going to be a really fun event.
And I know a lot of you who played, you're very focused on these leaderboards, as you should be. And so as you play this and you accumulate points, you work up a ladder of cards, and now each threshold rewards players with cards. So again, if you're thinking about leaderboard stuff, you want to get up, you want to get all those good cards so you get higher up in the rankings. So the final card is an exclusive event card. So players that finish a War Games event and collect the exclusive cards, they can opt to go heroic and replay the ladder for a stronger variant of that event card. So this is an event that's really gonna put your cards, your skill to the test. And if you can surpass that test, you get the good rewards. Between December 3rd, 12 p.m. Pacific, and December 10th, 12 p.m. Pacific, they're going to get an Adam Cole Cataclysm card.
Ooh, that's a nice gift. That is a very, very nice gift.
And you're going to get a sweet War Games card back.
Excited for that. I'm excited for that.
And 1,000 super coins.
Oh, jeez. Just throwing the coins away.
And we got more. And you get 25 draft picks.
Dang.
That means you hit that draft board and you get your cards, baby.
Get on it. Get on it.
So if you're new to the game, once you download it, you gotta go through the tutorial and all that, then it's gonna be a part of your bulletin board. For people who have been playing the game, it'll be there on your bulletin board. Go pick it up. It's just free. They don't have to do this. They want to do this. For who? For you.
That's even more incentive to make sure you take part in the War Games event. Exactly. My God, you get a super exclusive card if you win. That's amazing.
Exactly. Adam Cole, baby. Boom.
See, we just did it reverse. You went bay bay, and then I went boom. Because I want everybody for a loop.
As I was doing this, I was like, oh no, but I'm already here. So
and switched.
In my head, I was doing it right in my head. I was doing this in my head, but this came out of my body. I've had a long
week. You can't help it. It's really fun to point at yourself with your thumb.
It is. Big thumb pointer guys over here.
But that is so sick that there's an exclusive Adam Cole card.
Yes.
Anytime Adam Cole and new card is said, I'm excited. You got a happy camper. Yeah.
So season 7, SuperCard, it's out now. Download it. Jump into that war game starting December 3rd, baby.
And yes,
work through it. Work through those war games matches and get yourself these good exclusive cards. I want to thank you for being here.
Oh, my God. Of course. Anytime I get to chat with you about something, especially something like SuperCard, it's always a great, great time. So thanks for having me, man.
Of course, man. I appreciate it.
And absolutely.
Thank you guys for watching. Yes. Like we said, go download SuperCard, play it to your heart's content, be a part of this war game stuff, get your season 7 cards, work on your styles and all that business, your techniques. Just go and get it all. Go and get it all. Thank you for watching. And always and forever, keep it.